Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today.
With lichen planus, lichen means tree moss, and planus refers to flat. And the reason it's called that is because lichen planus is a flat-topped skin rash that looks a bit like tree moss. Lichen planus is an immune-mediated disorder, meaning that the immune system has started attacking its own skin, resulting in the rash. Lichen planus can also affect mucous membranes. Now, the skin is divided into three layers. The epidermis forms the thin outermost layer of skin. Underneath is the thicker dermis layer that contains the nerves and blood vessels. And finally, there's the hypodermis, which is made of fat and connective tissue that anchors the skin to the underlying muscle. The epidermis itself is made of multiple layers of developing keratinocytes, which are flat, pancake-shaped cells that are named for the keratin protein that they're filled with. Keratinocytes start their life at the lowest layer of the epidermis, called the stratum basale, or basal layer, which is made of a single layer of stem cells that continually divides and produces new keratinocytes. These new keratinocytes then migrate upwards to form the other layers of the epidermis. The stratum basale also contains another group of cells, the melanocytes, which secrete a protein pigment, or coloring substance, called melanin. As keratinocytes in the stratum basale mature and lose the ability to divide, they migrate into the next layer called the stratum spinosum, which is about 8 to 10 cell layers thick. The next layer up is the stratum granulosum, which is 3 to 5 cell layers thick. Keratinocytes in this layer begin the process of keratinization, which is the process where the keratinocytes flatten out and die. Keratinization leads to development of the stratum lucidum layer, which is 2 to 3 cell layers thick of translucent, dead keratinocytes. Finally, there's the stratum corneum, or the uppermost and thickest layer of the epidermis, which is like a wall of 20 to 30 layers, where the glycolipid acts like the cement and the dead keratinized cells are the bricks. Now, the part of the skin connecting the stratum basale of the epidermis to the underlying dermis is called the dermoepidermal junction. In healthy people, this junction looks like smooth waves between the epidermis and the dermis. But if you look closely at this junction, there are two parts. The first part is the lower portion of the plasma membrane of the keratinocytes in the stratum basale, which contains glue-like substances called hemidesmosomes. These hemidesmosomes adhere keratinocytes of the stratum basale to the second component of this junction, which is called the basal lamina. The basal lamina contains a group of molecules that provides structural and biochemical support to the keratinocytes. Typically, when a cell becomes infected with viruses or mutated by cancer, antigens from inside the cell will be presented on MHC1 molecules, which are found on all nucleated cells in the body. If this were to happen, then a specific cell of the immune system, called a cytotoxic T cell, would use its receptor to bind to the MHC class 1 molecule, which would cause it to release its payload of perforin and granzymes. Perforin would perforate the target cell by forming pores, and these pores would allow the granzymes to enter into the cell. Once inside, the granzymes would induce apoptosis, or programmed cell death. In lichen planus, some healthy, non-infected keratinocytes start presenting antigens on MHC1 molecules, and it's unclear why they do that. This antigen presentation on MHC1 molecules enables cytotoxic T cells to attack these keratinocytes and kill them. In killing the keratinocytes, these cytotoxic T cells also release cytokines, which recruit more cytotoxic T cells to the scene. That leads to more damage to the keratinocytes, as well as to the surrounding tissue in the basal lamina. That changes the shape of the dermoepidermal junction. It goes from looking like smooth waves to being more angulated and sawtooth-shaped. Also, melanocytes at the stratum basale become damaged, and they release their melanin, causing the skin to become darker or hyperpigmented. Over time, the damage caused by cytotoxic T cells extends beyond the stratum basale and the stratum spinosum and reaches the stratum granulosum. Keratinocytes in the stratum granulosum respond by increasing in both number and size, which causes the stratum granulosum to become thicker, and this is called hypergranulosis. Now, in some cases, this process gets triggered by a specific medication, like anti-malarial medication. And if a cause is identified, then it's called lichenoid reaction, rather than lichen planus. Now, symptoms of lichen planus mainly depend on the site of inflammation. If it happens in the skin, nails, or hair, then it's called cutaneous lichen planus, and it often affects the wrists and elbows. And if it occurs in the oral mucosa, then it's called oral lichen planus. Most of the time, cutaneous lichen planus and oral lichen planus are both present at the same time. An oral lichen planus typically affects individuals between ages 45 and 65. Lichen planus can be described using the six P's. The first P is for planar, meaning that the rash is flat-topped. The next P is for polygonal, which means that the rash has multiple sides. The next P depends on the diameter of the skin rash. If it's less than 5 millimeters in diameter, it's called papular, but if it's more than 5 millimeters, it's called a plaque. The next P is for the purple color of the skin rash. And the final P is for pruritic, meaning that it's itchy. Sometimes the surface of oral lesions are covered with white, reticular, or net-like lines called Wickham striae. In fact, that's the most common feature in oral lichen planus. The diagnosis of lichen planus is based on its appearance and can be confirmed with a biopsy that shows a sawtooth-shaped dermo-epidermal junction and a thickened stratum granulosum, or hypergranulosis. The treatment of lichen planus is geared at suppressing the immune system with corticosteroids. In a lichenoid reaction, the trigger is known, so that trigger is removed. All right, as a quick recap, lichen planus is an immune-mediated disorder in which keratinocytes in the stratum basale of the skin, or mucous membranes, are attacked. Individuals with the cutaneous form have a skin rash, while people with the mucosal form often have white papules covered by Wickham striae. Diagnosis can be confirmed with a biopsy that shows a sawtooth-shaped dermo-epidermal junction and a thickened stratum granulosum, or hypergranulosis. Treatment includes corticosteroids.